So we're here today with Greg Polica of the Ferndale City Council, who's running for re-election on November 7th. How are you doing today?
I'm great, Crystal. How are you?
Good. Can you talk a little bit about how long have you been on council and what are some of the things that you guys have accomplished in the time that you've been there?
Well, I've just finished my first year, my first term for 4 years, and I've accomplished a number of things since 2013. The city has passed a parks and recreation and streets and sewers bond, which is allowing us to do a lot of improvements across the city. And I've been a part of a lot of the discussions of what should happen in the parks. I'm currently on the Parks and Recreations Commission, working with some really great city residents in identifying amenities and new features that we're going to be putting into the parks over the next several years. As well as a couple of years ago, I had the opportunity to meet someone from University of Michigan who is starting a new program, becoming more interactive with communities. And we signed a 3-year contract with the U of M, and we have a number of students that come every semester and help the city identify small programs that can improve the quality of life of our residents.
Now, you aren't opposed in this election, so you've got another couple years left on council. What are some of the things that you'll be tackling in the coming years?
Well, I'd like to continue the project with the U of M, obviously. I'd also like to continue the work that we're doing on parks and recreation. And I'd like us to be more, or continue to be more fiscally responsible. I think we've done a really great job in the last 3 years. We've reduced the general fund by 3 mills. I'd like to see us continue to cut that, our tax rate, over the next couple of years, without impacting the quality of life and the services that we currently offer. There's going to be a number of things that the city's going to have to seriously look at. The Kulik Center is aging. We may be looking at either a new facility or finding a new building to move into. The Department of Public Works, their facilities are probably 60 to 70 years old. There's a lot of maintenance going on that we continue to do, and we may be investing in some new facilities for them as well. So I'd like to make sure that the investments that we do over the next year are going to be quality investments that provide the best for our community.
Now, can you talk a little bit about, I know one of the big issues that gets talked about in Ferndale is development and the parking deck. Can you talk a little bit about those?
Well, we just passed approval of the parking, the multi-use building. It's called the DOT, the Development on Troy, and it will contain retail on the first level, as well as 3 levels of parking, a lower level, underground parking as well, and then the top of the structure will have 2 floors of office. And what's really great is that we're trying to maximize the most use out of that space. Rather than build just something like a parking jail, we're building a multi-use facility so that we can, again, utilize the space as best as possible.
So can you talk a little bit about your work experience?
Well, for the last, or since 1998, I've worked for the Ford Motor Company. I'm currently in the Automotive Safety Office in government reporting. My daily duties really require that I generate reports that we send off to the government for government investigations.
Now, in this race, you don't have an opponent, but why should people still get out and vote?
Well, this is an interesting election, not just because the three of us who are running unopposed, but recently the state of Michigan has changed all the equipment for voting. And this will be the first election that we utilize this new equipment. And a lot of people aren't comfortable with change. So while there's not a huge change in the process of voting, the ballots are going to look different. The machines that you put the ballots into are going to be different. So I think this is a wonderful opportunity for people to come out, utilize the equipment, see how the change is going to impact them. So in the next election, which could be a very big election, you're not utilizing a lot of valuable time trying to figure out how the ballots work or how the machines work. You'll feel a little more comfortable with the experience. The other part is that it's a lot of people have died for the right for us to vote, and I have voted in every election. If you look back at my history, even some of the smallest elections where there's only been one person or one item on the ballot, I have voted, because voting is something that not everyone in the world is able to enjoy.
Now, if people do want more information about you, where do they go?
Best place is contact me on Facebook. I'm available. You can reach out to me there. I have a personal page as well as a Polica for Ferndale page.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thank you.